Welcome to the Roll Standard. I am Christopher, and I'm going to be your GM again as we continue to play Merc Borg. This is Cold and Deathless, Part 24, and, of course, Left is Law.
Hello, I'm Levi. I play Soup in Mel's body.
And I'm Jacob, and I play Curl.
So succinct.
In Curl's body.
In Curl's body.
And I'm Nate, and I play Melville Hugo Lesterborn in...
my body.
Soup's body, kind of.
For sure. Let's fuck up that track. Last we left you guys, you just killed some lady, didn't kill her daughter, in a tower or a keep outside of this town. And I guess last we left you guys was you guys swapping bodies and trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
And that puts us to this situation. It is dawn-ish, so let's just roll a d10 for miseries today, boys.
Oh, boy. Okay.
I will do this.
I can't watch this.
Ooh, nine.
That is a nine.
All right. Oh my God. It's a d8 tomorrow. So, all of that being said, we just like cut each other off with this.
I know. It's
all
great.
Day.
I rolled. God damn. I rolled 4 powers.
Oh, yeah. That's the other thing is roll powers for today as well.
Okay. Yeah.
So, Curl has 4.
And 1 omen.
Yep.
I have 2 omens.
Okay.
I have 2 powers.
Okay.
And I still got omens.
Oh, actually, you don't have to roll for omens because you still have some.
Then I am at 9 powers.
9. And, of course, Curl, you're at 15 out of 15 hit points.
Yeah, baby.
Mel, you're at 9 out of 16. And Soup, you're at 25 out of 25. And I'm saying that Mel and Soup, as I'm still calling Nate Mel. I'm still calling Levi Soup, just to prevent it from getting difficult. Although
let's not get weird.
I mean, let's get weird, but let's not get...
it's not
confusing.
Right.
Okay, Omens, Curl's got 1. Soup and Mel, you both have 3. Soulfire, Curl has 2. Mel, you got nothing left. Mm-hmm. And Soup, you got 1. We have 5 miseries active.
No big deal.
And active is like used in quotations.
Yeah.
Because they happened, but like they're difficult to like make your way through. Again, the flies.
There's
that's the big
flies.
One to me. The yes. Flies. We're in high altitude. Flies generally aren't. Yeah. Some have strayed, but.
And also, just not great for audio.
Yeah, do you really want to hear episode after episode of it's flies
exactly,
buzzing through all of it?
That's exactly
why.
I want
to feel like I'm there, Chris.
Right, because I do. And I know people that also do.
They're fucking sadists.
Yeah, right, that's why. Masochists, in that case. Ah. They prefer to be tortured. Anyway, what do you guys do? Do you guys have some free reign again?
Curl say, we kick rocks.
I'm sorry, but you're going to have to give me a minute.
For why?
Mainly... he needs pants, for one, on my body.
No, you look good. Much better than Acorn.
Yeah. Mel, I gotta live with this now.
Mel, you look down and you're more well endowed than usual. And it's a little refreshing.
That's a change because last time I said it was small.
Well, everything is big compared to Mel, apparently.
Yes, and Soup, unfortunately, the Acorn, as you've seen from another person's perspective.
It's worse
from
now.
When it's your own, it feels a lot smaller than it ever looked from other. Because it's yours, probably, and it feels terrible that it's that small.
This is the only win.
Curl, understand. You embarrassed. It's okay.
And Curl's going to rip the clothes off the dead woman and hand them off to...
that's terrifying.
To
that's her mother.
She's dead.
She's right there.
She is. She's at this... because before you left her upstairs, but now she's like at the top of the stairs where she can still like... she's in line with the ceiling of this first floor. And she's just watching you do this. And
oh,
just...
sorry.
I grab a light source. Is there a torch around here?
Oh, no.
There's a lantern on the table.
No! I grab the lantern and I break it over the body.
Oh, my God.
Just igniting the body?
Yes.
Okay. And the girl just begins sobbing.
Well, this is awkward. So you put clothes on, we should fucking kick rocks.
What is happening right now?
Yeah, okay, honestly, why did you... it's like, oh, I'm sorry, girl. Let me burn your mother. How did that
it's
make
a
it
funeral.
Better? I guess. I mean, okay. That's pretty badass, to be honest. Talking about badass, just disturbing.
Let's get the fuck out of here. This is already bad enough.
I guess I'll come to terms with this hideous body while we walk.
Why are you so...
look at this thing.
Yeah, I know. I lived in it.
I feel so bad for you.
You fucking...
and I don't know how you deal with these eyes.
If I ever find out that you're insulting me, I swear to God.
And I walk out.
For the first time, that's what you're left your line. Like, that's like... he insulted you for a whole episode earlier. Literally slapping him in the face.
Yeah, literally.
You guys head out of town and towards the mountains, and you realize that there's no more that hills and valleys to cross on your way here because you've arrived at the foot of these mountains. You look up at it, and you see that there is a building of some sort. It's hard to tell what exactly it is from this distance, but it's clearly a building. But you do notice that there is a fire in the hearth, assumedly by the plume of smoke out the chimney. And as you look at this, you realize that that's probably a good day's climb. As you look over the face of this mountain, you notice that there's not really a path. It looks like you're probably going to have to just plow your way through the snow.
You think that's the furnace miser?
It's hard to tell with the snow blindness that I'm getting from never being able to blink.
Yeah, bullshit.
Or you can squint.
Everything here is now fucking 480p for me, okay?
480p?
Your eyes were horrible.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You can see. I bet you can see as good as Karen right now.
Oh, Karen, she can see fantastic.
That wasn't the point.
She's always been my eyes in a sense.
Now she doesn't have to be.
I'm so sorry.
And that thing. Learn how to use it.
This acorn? God damn it, I don't know how to use this acorn.
No, you fucker. You piece of shit. No. The crossbow that you have on your back. Learn how to use it.
I'm just saying I could just poke it in.
Oh, my fucking God. I walk up the mountain.
Curl is a little confused. Mel?
Yes?
What's going on? Why are you always fighting now? I don't understand. You just share bodies, we go.
Share bodies? You want to swap with me, little boy?
Bright Lord can fix this, yes.
I feel like that's not true at all.
Then what can your Bright Lord not do? Can he fly?
Yes.
Let's just... Can we please go? I'm not doing great here as it is. I feel like a half a dead man.
Yeah, we go get shiny.
But you're alive.
True. But I think that makes it worse. You're better off the way you are now.
Am I? Karen has to look at this hideous body. Is she even attracted to my personality or is it just my body before? I have no idea.
You're talking about a bird. I don't know what you're talking about.
Excuse me. She's more than a bird. She is my wife.
Yes, that part has disturbed me for quite some time. Now, can we please go?
It's not like
go?
It's been her choice can to be
we,
a bird.
Can
I'm
we
just saying.
Please?
That beautiful feather body of hers.
You say creepy things about Karen, you feel the mountain start to kind of rumble. And snow starts barreling down the mountain at you guys.
Fuck.
All three of you give me an agility test. We're going to call this DR-16, because that's what's up to work.
DR-16.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, of course not.
What's an unnatural zero?
Failed.
Thank God for that.
What's a natural zero?
Yeah, right. How do you... Oh, no.
Actually, I think a natural zero is a 2-2 or whatever you rolled.
I got a 10.
I mean, I got that right. Yeah. You got a 10?
Right. Yeah.
What about you there, Soup?
I got a 14.
Nice. Oh, that's not nice.
You could lower it.
You can. You can omen that shit to safety.
Omen to lower
it. I'm going to omen it.
You're going to omen it?
Yeah.
You're just going to omen it to lower the DR?
Honestly, correct. I should probably try.
If you can, if it... yeah, because what?
I just have to re-roll, but I wouldn't make it. It would just be a re-roll try, but
oh, I, got
I do have three omens and...
For an avalanche, I would...
It's a fucking avalanche.
Yeah.
It feels like a thing that you would definitely want to avoid.
Yes.
If you at all possibly can, and this allows you to be. All
right.
Go for it.
What about you, Jake?
Oh, wait. Nope. Still didn't work.
But all right.
Damn it.
What about you there, Mr. Single Omen?
I face the wall and just grit my teeth.
It's a brace for impact.
Oh, yeah. No.
And you do, and this smashes you in the face as the other two go running behind, running down the hill. And just like, you both are running. Okay, you know what? Give me another agility test, both of you runners.
Oh, my God.
At a DR-12.
Oh, no.
This is just for fun.
For who?
It doesn't seem
me!
Fun.
Clearly!
Absolutely not.
Oh, I did.
Okay, so, Soup, you're just running down the hill, and you see Mel... just start tumbling.
And I leap over him.
Yeah, well, sure.
With a 20.
Oh, really? No, nice.
Not,
okay.
Not
I had
natural.
A, I had
not
a zero,
natural.
So.
Yeah. Oh, well, then sure, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, he just goes tumbling past you, and you leap over him, and you continue running. Curl, bracing for impact. Snow smacks him in the face, just buries him. give me a 2d6.
Oh, cool. That's a 34.
Oh, so seven. I said 2d6. Not d66. So 7 damage. Okay, so you're down to 8. Oh, you have armor, don't you?
Yeah.
We'll allow that to affect it because it's like.
Can I use it?
Yeah, I would allow
cool
this
beans.
One.
Oh, fuck.
6 damage.
6 total.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, and then you're down to 9. All right.
Cool.
Mel, since you tumbled, I feel like you're going to take 1d6 damage.
Okay.
1, and I do have armor, so...
Can't possibly not negate it, so just...
Baby.
No damage, it just hurts a lot.
Catch a fucking break.
And the snow, or the avalanche, settles. Curl, nowhere to be found.
Back again!
When you do hear him faintly...
Get Curl out!
Very clear where he is.
PTSD!
That's probably true.
Karen, did you see where Curl turned up? Were you paying attention?
Ah!
By that treetop over there?
Ah!
What do you mean?
Ah!
She just flies off.
That wasn't very helpful this time, Karen.
Well, I thought it felt like it was. It was like a no, are you crazy, and I'm out of here.
Okay, well, there you go.
I mean, a yes? I don't know. Actually, I don't know either.
just completely flipped.
Right. Mel laying in, not so much a snowball, but just a pile of snow and bent limbs on the ground, and Soup just standing there over Mel's beaten body.
You want a hand up there, compadre?
Yes, please.
And I grab him by his booty shorts?
You're the one wearing booty shorts.
You're also wearing booty shorts, per Jake.
If I helped a friend up wearing booty shorts, both of us in this case, I guess.
He's face down, right?
Yeah, but I'd be like, hey, give me your hand, bro. Not like, let me grab your tiny little shorts there, baby. Talking to you guys. Baby!
This has been an ongoing thing for
him, just
going
to grab him by the belt and stand him up.
Okay. And he stands up, and you, Mel, brush yourself off, and you guys look up at the mountain, kind of looking for where exactly Curl might lie, and you see that this avalanche has uncovered a massive skull buried under the snow, and you notice that it's buried up to the middle of the nose, nasal cavity. So,
well, holy shit.
There's a bright light glowing out of the eyes, and you can see it from this distance.
Well, let's find Curl and inevitably hear how much he wants to go loot the place.
I think I see the top of his broom over there, so...
Yeah, let's go then.
You go up there and you see Curl's broom sticking out of the snow.
Use that fucking cool arm of yours.
Yeah, that's what I picked you up with. It kind of seems familiar in a way. Kind of weird.
Horrible and foreign. So, all power to you.
Yeah, with this horrified demonic Dennis arm, you just make short work of digging Curl out, and he's just laying there on his back,
smiling,
staring up at you as you uncover him.
You all right, friendo?
You all right there?
No, Curl, face hurt real bad.
I'm sure.
Yeah, I mean, there was a boulder in that snow, so.
Yeah, Curl found.
Found Curl.
Come on out. There's a skull up there now we should get to.
Why, true. Curl already got lots of skulls at home.
No, turn around, look.
Oh, you shiny in there.
The bright light calls you, Curl.
Okay, Curl interested. You sure? How we get in?
We walk in, I'm assuming.
That's a ways off now, I can't tell.
Yeah, it looks like it's about an hour hike up the mountain to the skull, and you see the building that you were heading towards. Still about a half a day's hike.
Okay, side detour, we get loot, pull scam. Get shiny.
Okay, I don't. The pull scam.
Yeah, what's that with Curl and like scamming?
he
says it a lot.
Your
like, never
scam
really
likely
happens.
In is probably not good for us.
Yeah.
I mean, look what happened last time you tried to pull scam. Never. You murdered a mother, and I'm in his fucking body now.
Curl, give funerals. She fine.
Yeah, you just lit her aflame.
No, all I'm saying is that you've never succeeded in a scam.
No, Curl always do.
Look, I think you just look, call stealing things scams.
He opens his bag of silver and shows him.
Look, Curl, good.
Holy
scam.
Shit.
Yeah, yes,
you
Curl.
Might have scammed me a couple times, but that's as efficient
well,
as your scam
you
has
easy
been.
Scam. I mean,
he's so good at scamming, you don't even
think yeah, we place. Don't even think that he's scamming.
All
that's
this
so
is happening while we're walking up
yes.
this
yeah, yeah. A good scam is not noted as a scam.
You're absolutely right.
See, Curl only know that you find out bad scams. You don't know about all scams.
Oh my god.
And he licks his
like,
lips.
So we're heading up to this skull.
Yes. As you guys get closer, you see that the eyes emit this beautiful glow through these pinholes in a way. It looks like they're through really narrow chambers, and immediately, Mel, you kind of get this PTSD flashback of narrow chambers. But the nose, which is then you immediately think of that, Mel, is a possible alternative that's not going to kill you, perhaps.
Mm-hmm.
You see that the nose is obscured, the nasal cavity, by a curtain of like wet and weird viscera.
Boogies.
Yeah, dangling, blocking light, but you see there's kind of the glow.
Okay, there is shiny in there.
I mean, literally, yes. I don't know what it is.
Just don't touch boogies.
Why? No.
And I get on all fours and crawl under them.
Crawl under me?
No, the boogies.
The dangling nose cavity things.
Oh, yeah. You notice, too, that they do dangle to the floor.
I wait a second.
For a breeze to come by? For it to inhale? Or what?
Yeah,
the floor is not going to get windy here, girl. You're going to have to push through there if that's where you're going.
I take my staff and I tap one of the boogies.
It does nothing. It just kind of wiggles, dangles.
Freezes. No.
I guess it could, yeah. Yep, yeah, it freezes.
So if I touch it, does anything happen?
It freezes.
No, oh, I mean with that my skin.
No.
I'm going to walk up and open it so he can crawl under it.
Okay, as you do that, Soup, give me a toughness test, DR10.
Yuck.
That is a 17.
Okay, this thing stings. Oh, no, never mind. It doesn't. It does sting a little bit. That's it.
Yeah, let me through there quick.
All right, I guess I'll hold the door. Come on, Kroll. Keep crawling.
I scamper.
You're holding up an area of this, and you notice it's not really enough to completely avoid all of it. It's quite a deep cavity full of these things.
Let's get the fuck in here. I'll just push through.
Okay. Toughness test, DR10.
I grab onto his belt.
Absolutely not.
You feel that?
Yes.
Yeah, you feel this burning of these tendrils, and you're infected.
This stupid pink fleshy body.
Girl?
You're so weak.
I was attached to him, so do I have to roll again?
Oh, yeah, if he's pulling you through it all.
Yep. Oh, my God. Oh, I got it. Yeah. 16.
Okay, yeah, it stings too, but it's, you know, doesn't do anything more than that. It kind of feels like a dying jellyfish trying to sting you. But Mel, doesn't really feel like that jellyfish is dying.
Oh, God damn it.
Feels like he is.
Soup, hand me one of my med packs.
Oh, okay, yeah, I mean,
I was already feeling kind of shit before this.
Right, you can take all of these. I had none on my body, so it does make sense for me to keep them. You want this scroll back, too?
I don't want to touch a scroll ever again.
All three of you give me a group presence check. And we don't generally do these, but group presence in this situation is done by rolling and applying the party's highest presence value to the roll. In this case, obviously, it's going to be the Mel body.
Right.
So it's a +6, I believe?
Yep.
Okay. Everybody roll or just one person roll?
Just one person rolls.
Okay.
Baby!
22.
That's
nice.
A 22.
Okay, wonderful. And then somebody give me a D4.
Go for it.
I'll do it back to back. Right. 2.
You guys get to the other side of this curtain of danglies. The end of this little tunnel, though, opens up to what would apparently be the sinus cavity of this giant or whatever this is. And you see that there is a rickety scaffolding leading up and down. But as you guys kind of take this in and Melville, you dig through this med pack, you hear footsteps and you see two goblins come from the floor below, up the stairs. Somebody give me 2d6.
2 and a 3.
5.
A 5. They immediately see you and they just start angrily yelling. You can't understand a word they're saying because they clearly are speaking.
Go fuck yourself!
Is that what they're saying? Yeah, fuck yourself, right? I don't wait.
Curl speak goblin.
All right, let me put this med pack to use quick because I want to get involved in this shit.
Okay, so you guys, they were clearly pissed at you guys.
Right.
Who knows about what? And then you guys yelled back. They both draw.
It's a game fight.
These rusty knives from their meager belts.
If I see that, I draw the crossbow.
Okay, great. And roll initiative. Let's get it on.
Get it, Melbert.
All right. That's us.
Be careful with that flame and sword there.
I know. I've used it.
Okay, so what do you guys do first?
Med pack.
Med pack, you're going to use that turn to do that? Okay, and then you don't have to roll for it. It's just a use of it, and you get rid of your
infection.
But yep. It also heals you D6.
Not,
if it doesn't.
He got rid of. He used it to get rid of the infection first. He used it again to heal.
It's one or the other.
Oh, I thought it was both.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Nope. It's one or the other.
So, curl and soup.
I shoot.
Shoot that crossbow.
I shoot the crossbow.
Okay. Give me that. 12. Actually, DR14.
I miss.
You loose a crossbow bolt, and this goblin very quickly just dodges out of the way and it smashed inside of the skull and bolt shatters.
Might need to find another weapon. I'm running low on bolts here.
Yeah, no shit.
That being the case, how many do you have?
3 more.
3 more. Okay, good to know.
Mm-hmm.
That leaves us then with Curl.
I swing my broom of power. Icy fierceness.
You're gonna sweep him away.
Wow, that was a weird roll.
That was cool.
15.
15? Okay, that hits.
That's max damage!
It is.
Oh my god, it is.
Do they have any armor?
They do have some, yes. D2.
A tweezers?
Well,
yeah.
My worst.
He did a 12 damage.
No, I know.
But 6 is physical.
Yeah.
4 physical.
Tell me about it.
Woo! I take my bristles and I stab him in the eyeball and his head explodes.
Okay. That's pretty funny.
No fuck with Curl in the gang!
And that was, like, unnecessary amount of explosion. Like, if Mel was to do that with a broom, it wouldn't have done that. But Curl did.
I killed something.
Yes, you did. And now you're fucking going bloodthirsty. It's bloodthirsty rage. The rush of combat is addictive. You're always chasing that high. It's kill or be killed. You can't stop to ask questions. When landing an attack that kills a creature, you must move and attack another. This may include allies, adding d6 damage for every creature slain.
Oh, that's fucking
your onslaught stops when you fail to kill and you fall to the ground exhausted, losing your next turn. So, in other words, I got to imagine that you're
3d6 on this next one if I get it.
Yep, on this next goblin. So, go ahead, give me that attack roll as you...
I just keep going?
Until you don't kill them. And that includes everybody around you. Like, if you hit Soup all of a sudden afterwards and you don't kill him...
Even though my turn was done with that first swing, I just keep going afterwards. I would be shooting around like a bullet.
Actually, that doesn't make sense. You're right. Your next turn, you would have to.
Okay, that makes way more sense.
Okay, that's a great point.
Terrifying.
Yeah. How is this, like, is it like a combo?
Curl's literally
a combo.
We're
saying. He's just teleporting.
Think about, like, the fact that, like, you were, like, fighting, like, 30 goblins, right? Which is a crazy amount.
Right.
But you're killing each one of them? You killed 30 in 6 seconds?
No fucking
You can't kill 5 per second? It's just like accelerating. It's like
3d6 next time.
So we're going to call you raging or bloodthirsty. This is called
curl thirsty.
Curl thirsty. that sounds like he wants curl. He's about out. I don't know.
One goblin's turn.
Yep, it is the one goblin's turn, and I'm actually going to have him roll morale.
No, I bet you are.
Well, no, it's because...
scared the shit out of him.
Right. So why don't Levi, why don't you give me that roll? Or whoever. Ooh, I don't care who.
2d6, right?
No, morale is actually a d20.
Oh.
And to refresh that, because we don't do a lot of morale rolling either.
Nope.
And I'm just like, we've been playing this game for a long time, and I'm starting to see that there's certain things that I have left out, and no one ever has problems with it. They're just like asking why.
Mm.
And to be honest, more often than not, it's just that I fucking forgot. So, yeah, it's a 2d6. You're exactly right. So you're going to have to roll over a 7 here in order for him to do one of these things.
I got you.
That is a 7 on the dot.
Yikes.
So over the creature's morale. So that technically is not over it. Therefore, he's still doing what he's been doing.
All right.
He goes and...
Ballsy.
Yeah, really. He flips the blade in his hand and stabs Curl right in the chest. Curl, give me an agility test. DR 14.
Maybe you should use an omen.
I'm going to probably use an omen.
Okay, you failed that, in other words?
Oh, yeah.
What did you fail to
reroll? It would have been a 1.
It would have been a 1? Okay, yeah. So we want to spend your 1 omen to reroll?
Fuck, what is it?
A 14.
Oh, you failed.
Agility.
God damn it. It didn't matter.
Okay, so
I got a 10.
Take D4 damage, minus your armor, of course.
1 damage.
I want to read this to you guys, because in the Goblin Curse, I've been kind of keeping under wraps. Let's explain what it is. All goblins carry a curse. Once like you, they are now trapped in the prison of their crazed goblin flesh. Only their eyes reveal the truth, a ruined mind watching its body perform terrible deeds. Even being attacked by goblins sends the curse, carried on the winds of their hate. Hit or miss, it doesn't matter. In the dark of Sarkash, they shoot at passersby with twanging bows. You must find and kill the goblin before your mind is paralyzed. If the curse-carrying creature still lives d6 days after the attack, you will warp irrevocably into one yourself.
Oh, fuck.
Then, only the dark of Sarkash will hide you. So, in other words...
Murder this bitch!
Yeah, you get attacked by a goblin, and he doesn't even have to hit you? You have to kill him within d6 days.
Boys.
So at this point, technically, this goblin has goblin cursed Curl.
Oh my fucking God.
All right, let's go.
Yeah.
Go. Fuck.
So, roll initiative. Right?
6, that's us.
That is you going.
I fucking jump on this thing and strangle him. Oh, no, I'm going to take my broom.
Yep.
And I'm going to try to spear him through the chest to the ground.
Okay, like Trident style?
Theory.
Aquaman? All right, give me that DR14.
That's an 18.
Now, what is your strength? You have a plus or something there, right?
Two.
Okay, cool. Good to know. Yep, so you got him.
5 physical?
Yep.
I would assume.
And
that
you have to kill him, so you're actually adding, because you're 2d6 already, right? 1d6 physical, 1d6 cold. Now 1d6 raging.
It's 2 physical, 6 cold. And then another 6 for raging.
Tell me about it.
Oh, my God.
That's not cool, man.
No, it's not.
His eyes, there's just blood pouring out of his eyes as he swings around in a mad fury, taking his broom and stabbing it through this goblin's chest and spearing to the ground. And then he rips the broom back out and leaves an ice spear of blood coming out.
I love that. That's very cool.
He turns around.
I'm terrified of it.
And he turns around and looks at Mel and Soup. You're fucking next!
What is going on?
Fucking run, buddy, you need to move.
We're going to do something here. We're going to keep initiative going. Mm. But now, on a 1-3, Curl goes first. On a 4-6,
Curl
already moved initiative round. Oh, also,
boys,
not that this is much of a consolation, but Curl's no longer goblin cursed.
And add 4d6.
And we'll find out after the break.
Next.
Yeah, great. and welcome back to the World Standard. Curl!
No!
Curl, bloodthirsty rager. Fortunately, Melville and Soup's turn. So, what are you guys doing as you see Curl threatening you guys? And also, you see that his eyes are bleeding. He's like, he's clearly, something's wrong.
What do we do about this situation here?
I think maybe you should run. And I pull out the torch that I gave to Soup before.
Oh, the mortal torch?
Yes.
Whatever. You're going to run up there and beat him? You look pretty beaten as it is. Why don't I just
because,
get up there? And...
Come on, guys.
Because I'm telling you right now, he'll fucking murder you.
I don't know if he can do that. I'm the one with soul fire here. Soul potency.
Yeah, and that's...
Highlander rules, bitch.
Highlander rules! That means that if you die, you lose them anyway. That's a fucking waste. Or you get the fuck out of here. Now. And I fucking light up the torch.
Curl, kill another deathless! Yes, it's gonna be fucking stole stealing.
Yep, so I light up the torch and I go in.
Yeah, but okay, nope. So the torch...
keeps me alive for an hour. He can't kill me with the next attack.
Yeah, I can't outright kill him.
He can't kill me.
Oh, it'll stop him.
Yeah. Yes.
But don't you die
But if you get hit...
But he's only alive for an hour.
Yeah, but he's not going to hit me for a 25. It's not possible.
4d6, motherfucker?
It's only 24.
That's a good point.
Oh, my God, that's right.
It's only 24.
He could crit him.
He won't crit me.
A crit could kill him. He's a 5% chance of killing you at this point. Ultimately, right. Mel and Soup, figure out what you're doing.
Yep.
Mel, you drew the torch.
Yep.
We call that what you did.
Mm-hmm.
Soup, what are you doing then?
I just have to roll dice, man. That's it.
All right. Your decisions are, like, not in your hands anymore. I kind of like that. I do that all the time when it comes to, like, who I'm targeting. When there's no obvious aggro, you
mm-hmm.
know? Obvious aggro. That's
We're
like...
literally two Mel standing in a room. Like, there's no obvious aggro.
Yes. Passive boys and this aggressor.
Yep.
No, I mean, that's, like, why the goblin attacked Curl, though, is because I went with aggro there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cause he's like, oh, you fucking killed him.
Absolutely.
And he also didn't
I don't see why he would ever try to run towards us instead.
Yeah. He's at 9 hit points. And you
it does
that,
make sense.
He does look hurt.
It does make sense at the same time that, like, Curl has never turned on him for any reason.
No. Or anyone.
This is very, like, hey, why's my cat rabbit all of a sudden? Why did he claw me? He doesn't bite. Well, that's weird. Two different things.
I'm just going to stand next to Mel and wait and see what happens here. I mean, I'm not gonna run.
So you're just going to kind of wait?
Yeah.
Okay. So roll initiative then. And as we said, 1 through 3 is a Curl. The Curl.
Oh, fuck.
It's a Curl.
Oh, fuck.
Congratulations, it's a Curl.
Yep.
Okay, so wait, before you flip it, what are you assigning the two sides? Because you're clearly attacking
You're
going to
flip that
board.
Directly.
No, you know, you let him decide.
No way. That's Curl's decision. If he wants to flip the coin for it, then be my guest. But, okay, is it Soup 1, Mel?
One is Soup, 2 is Mel.
I gotcha.
That's
you had a real flip. Mel.
Oh, boy.
Oh, fuck. Here we go.
That's why I had it.
Oh!
You would
have died!
You would have died! He rolled a fucking nat 20, which was, in our discussion, was the only way he could have killed Soup, but really?
I mean, oh my god.
He might kill Mel.
Wait.
Okay, okay.
No, there's no way, man.
Oh, right, he can't.
I pulled that fucking torch out for a reason.
Oh my god, Jake, you would have killed me.
What do you think? This is my argument.
Well, wait, dude, only if
time,
you somehow
time,
got more than 25 damage.
The whole time
damage,
you guys were talking about it, just like that natural one I got, I felt it in my soul. I was like, I'm going to fucking... As soon as you're like, only a natural... He's not going to crit.
There's no way.
It's like, 4d6 crit.
Yeah, but you know, that's only double damage.
I mean, you'd still have to roll it, but the higher likelihood that you hit over 25 right now is
you roll all of your dice that you're going to roll, and then we just double that result.
Yeah. So
or I will allow you to double the amount of dice you roll.
No, fuck that.
Either one of those is fine because they both don't really make a difference.
Right.
All
right.
Whatever, let's see if we can get through
your
this.
Preference.
What armor do you have?
It's a minus a d4.
Okay, so 2 physical.
So that's 4 physical with the crit. 1 armor.
5 cold.
Which is 10 cold. I'm down already.
you're down.
Yeah, that's 9
okay,
HP.
So I'm just beating the corpse
oh,
now.
Yeah.
That's 4.
That's 8 more.
And 10.
And then 10 more. Oh my fucking god.
I take the...
That's like 30 damage.
30 damage?
Yeah, that's a lot.
I got the torch out.
I figure I'm just beating him with the back end of my fucking broom, beating your face in, and you're looking like Glenn from The Walking Dead.
Oh,
but the
you
Glenn'd
him?
You alive.
You Glenn'd him?
Yeah.
Oh, I like it. Okay, yeah, and Melville laying there on the ground, like, Curl thinks he's fucking spent, but Melville just kind of gets up a little bit, and Curl just collapses to the ground.
What just happened? And...
Ouch! Wow, you look bad.
Oh.
He's still alive, though. He looked good. Yeah. No, still alive.
Not for very long.
I mean, your face is kind of filling in a little bit. It doesn't look so concave, but why did you do that?
Girl, not know.
Girl. What the fuck, man?
He just felt like he had to. I don't know.
Yeah, how does that feel now? Honestly.
I'm a little tired.
Oh, you're a piece of shit too, aren't you, everybody?
Curl, I got to imagine too that like your memory of what just happened when you're in those seeing red moments, very vague. You know what I mean? Like you kind of know
that
you
girl
did
not know.
You don't know exactly what you did though.
Small little bump on the head, huh, Mel?
No, I can tell.
I mean,
it's magic keeping me alive at this point, fellas.
And I just kind of lift up the torch a little bit.
Torch is flickering pretty well.
I found this a little while ago when we pulled you out of the hole.
So we just stick you with needle?
Oh, God, no. The fact that I can even talk right now is actually kind of impressive. I think this is kind of it, boys. Like, I tried, but honestly, I wasn't wrong when I said your body was just pink and fleshy soup.
I mean, I've never taken a beating from Curl, so I wouldn't know. What happens when that torch goes out here? If you say that's the only thing keeping you alive right now, is that what you said? Magic?
That's 100% the truth. I don't got real much else in me. Curl, I don't know what the hell we did to piss you off, but...
Not do nothing, Curl. Just, you react. Been a long day.
GM, what happens when this torch goes out?
I feel like you know.
I don't remember.
He dies.
No!
That's why I said you feel like you know, because I feel like that's what you were thinking. He did 30 damage to you, right?
Yeah.
That's past broken.
And you had 9?
Yes.
You're down to negative 21.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's nothing that's going to fix this.
Right. I mean, if you could heal him for 21 hit points in the next hour, then yes. 22, because you got to be at, well, you could be at 0.
Curl's going to pick Mel up and throw him over his hump and walk out of this bitch.
I mean, you're a strong boy. We can handle that. You're just walking back out?
I'm going to go bury him.
What, he's still alive right now. He can help us.
I had time.
Help him bury the hole. Dig the hole?
No, he,
that is just cruel.
Curl feel bad. He not know how to do this. Mainly, Curl just kill and be done. But Curl kind of like you, Mel, so you do the right thing.
He's going to bring him outside.
He's still alive here.
He gonna die? How you fix this, huh, Soup?
We don't know. We don't know he's going to die.
This seems real desperate.
We don't know how this torch works.
You know exactly how this works, Soup. Shut the fuck up. Think about it for a second. It's just you two now. Got it?
I mean,
and Karen.
There's Karen. That's three. You forget about her sometimes.
Yeah, sure, yeah. Okay, it's you three now. Realistically, you've lost, less now, to be fair. But you've lost a third of anything that we could all get done when we were together. Man, I really wish it wasn't you two that I was saying goodbye to.
Can I talk to you for a second here, away from him?
Okay, Colonel, go make crypt now.
Yeah, you go dig a hole.
Right, yeah. What do you need, Soup?
I don't think I can make it with this guy. This guy's kind of a loose cannon. You know, I've only brought him back because I know that's what you want to do. That's why I always bring you back first. The couple times I've done it.
I mean, that does make sense.
I never know what this guy's going to do.
You're right.
Oh, I mean, what happened?
More... Oh, God damn it. More right now than you've ever been.
His lung is on the ground.
Oh, God. It sucks that actually hurts still.
I mean, this is kind of weird because that's my lung. And what's going to happen now? How am I going to get back in my body?
Oh, God. Buddy,
I'm gonna be stuck with these forever now.
Yeah, you could probably learn to blink them.
What a selfish prick. He's just dying here. He's like, my body!
No, how much? Ah, that's fair.
But it's my body.
But a lot of people, like, when someone is dying, they're like, what about me? Like, because they worried about how that affects. I mean, that's normal. Yeah. It is selfish, but it's normal. It's a normal response. Like, how am I going to whatever now after you gone? That's very common.
My lungs!
It's true.
Damn attachments. I just got attached to his body. I mean, I
really wish it wasn't you two here. Like, I really, when I was alive, like,
I'm not your first choice, I understand.
God,
this.
No. Fuck, none of you are. I had a pretty fucking sweet life for a while there.
Meanwhile, you can see Curl in the back building an igloo.
Oh, like a memorial igloo?
Yep.
I like it.
Now I'm just gonna be forgotten on this mountain.
Give me an agility test to determine if you do that. We're gonna call it a DR-12.
It's an 8.
So you see Curl, like, Mel and Soup are here arguing about Mel and Soup. And you see Curl in the background, like, stacking ice blocks that he's created. Collapse. And he's standing beside it, just frustrated.
Fuck. Curl's not good at this shit. Sentimental bullshit.
Whatever you decide to do, Soup. just fucking actually decide to do it. All right? We've argued about this too many times, whether you're fucking coming or going or whatever. You're almost there, friend. Okay? I know we don't get along, and that would never have changed if I was gonna be alive. I understand that as well. But I'll tell you now, you got a good fucking chance with that actual body of yours. Mine. And you got a useful hawk and the crazy kid. I don't really know what else to give you, friend.
I know, you can say it. She's beautiful, I know.
God.
She's the best part of me, okay? I'm sorry.
He's really into his wife. That's sweet.
Yeah, endearing.
I mean, yeah, I like it.
I know we've had our issues, and I'm sorry for that. I'm stuck in my old ways here, but...
I'm an asshole too, Soup. I get it.
I'm not ready to be alone with him.
And I'm not ready to die. I'm in shock right now, all right? And it's weird when I'm not, like, in straight-up shouting mode.
Okay. Real talk here. You want to be buried in that igloo? Is that fine?
Oh my god!
Oh, he's switched to branches.
I'm
gonna be a pyre now.
What do you want? What do you want as your final hurrah? Of course, you're gonna be dead. I hate thinking this way.
I don't hate being an ever-burning pile on a mountain.
Is that what you want to be?
That sounds pretty cool.
I mean, we could probably burn this skull down.
Fucking figure out what's going on inside of it if you can, at least. Christ. Make it worth walking in there for.
Worth your death? But what if he does that again?
That's a good question.
So I have made pyre. We put you to sleep with
When did you get back in here?
Curl was here the whole time. He just done building pyre because igloo not work.
Clearly, look at that dilapidated thing.
Dilapidated,
that's Levi.
You be careful, Soup. You may be in male body, but I still put you in that dilapidated fucking igloo.
Yeah, stop it. God damn it. If there's anything that
how
you
can
guys...
we survive this?
I'm the one who argues with Soup, all right?
Ah, fine. Look, Mel, Curl does feel bad, but he didn't
you
mean...
You fucking should, to be honest. Mm. I don't know, I'm not... I'm a kind of a piece of shit, too, so... I can't really blame anybody. Just find your fucking Bright Lord, all right?
I will tell Bright Lord of you.
And Curl wipes a bloody tear away.
Is Mel laying on the ground this whole time?
Yeah.
Okay, for some odd reason, I just pictured him standing there with the torch. He's like, he's just going to crawl in there and just like...
No, I imagine...
Like, he's totally fine.
I imagine I found like a mountain tree or something, propped him up, and then they were having this conversation. I was just trying to build a fucking memorial for him.
Mm-hmm. And it's like, oh, no, you guys are up at this place. So yeah, I guess maybe that avalanche even uncovered some stuff. Enough for you guys to interact with.
Right. Scene. And I cruelly write what Curl would think is lettering for Melbert. In the snow.
Isn't even Melbert.
I know.
No, and it's funny that, like, no, it's like, because Curl writes in, like, we've kind of already discussed this, that he writes in, like, pictures.
Yes.
Pictographs, so, like, the pictures are, like, is indicative of Melville.
There's an acorn.
But it's not quite. Yeah, but it's, like, not quite right. Like, the eyes, like, it's like an acorn and, like, two eyes. The eyes are slightly closed. Like, it's someone else, slightly.
Oh, man.
I like it.
Soup, you have nothing to say before we chuck body?
I'm sorry. This is a very unconventional funeral. Usually the person isn't there for it.
He's usually dead. Yeah.
We're just waiting. I don't know how long you stay alive.
Yeah, it's not much longer, realistically. I mean, in the grand scheme of things.
You want some frog before go? You know, last meal?
Yeah, I mean, I got some food in that satchel there. With my scrolls.
I'm actually still alive. Wait. Why not?
He's a cannibal. His original stats, he's like, he can eat human flesh even when alive.
Yes.
Might as well use this once before it dies.
It was pretty good.
Your last meal is going to be the leg of some random dude.
Yeah.
Or arm. Or
the arm.
Yeah.
Why the fuck not? I don't give a shit.
And somehow, Kaelin ended up in this one.
That was the goal.
In Mel's last meal.
I'm going to burn my own body in a way. This is kind of fucking me up a little bit.
Yeah, that's got to be really weird.
Like burying yourself.
Can you, the only thing I ask is that you don't wait until like I kind of wind down to the last like minute and then do it because I'd rather it not be painful.
I'm going to take
So you want us to wait till after
I'm actually dead, all yes.
Right. What about my stuff on you?
You can take it.
Go I'm going to take out my book, my weird ass book.
The black book.
I'm going to take that out and then I'm also going to take out my silver cup worth of 30 silver.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to give them to Mel as gifts.
Oh, like in his, like, sarcophagus kind of thing?
Yeah.
Like stuff to be buried with?
I'm going
to
put him in his pockets.
I'm still alive.
Yeah, he's just like watching you put, trying to shove this giant book into his tight ass booty short pockets.
Cup is for you. Me repay. I did take some money, maybe. I don't know. But book will probably help you find peace in your end time. Instead of arguing with both of us, it show you things.
Dude, that's actually pretty good considering what it shows you. Like, it's your own thoughts on paper.
Holy fuck, dude.
It's like his own eulogy, just like reading his own eulogy because he's thinking it. That's crazy.
So, Mel, girl, love you. But it is time for you go, and you don't need us here for that.
I mean, this is kind of your fault, Curl, so...
Look, you get the burnt body, I understand. It is yours. You burnt body, we let Mel have one moment of peace. He's been with us a long time. He probably fucking irritated.
What's up, GM?
Nothing.
What?
Oh, God, it's good. You want your body back, you're gonna get it. Just wait. This is terrible. You're gonna hate it.
And Curl turns around and... walks towards the pyre and sits and waits.
He was waiting for him to die.
Yep, giving Mel his moment of peace in the end.
Are you reading the book?
Yeah.
What does it say?
It would be what Mel could think of writing down. Like, it. I think it would be like,
Dear Diary.
Kind of, honestly.
Very Arthur.
Yeah.
That was 100% Arthur.
But a bit of an account of, like, back in Belphegor, all the bullshit, you know? Like, if you can do it as fast as thought, it'd be quite a bit easier to do than actually
writing.
Why
don't you just sing that song you always sing?
Wanted to do it!
This is your place, bro!
Yeah, no. It's not like he doesn't have a fucking ego, too, so, like, hey, man, if somebody's gonna keep an account of some bullshit, like, this is it here. I guess it will probably make it to killing the gravekeeper and just getting into the spirit rising up out of the grave. And then trails off into nothing.
And you see the torch fade. He's kind of propped up reading this book. You see that he just kind of stops moving. Like, he's not turning pages anymore. He's just staring.
Soup, you help with body?
Yeah. We carry him over to the pyre.
Okay.
And put him on it.
All right.
Because he read that book and died, can we make up an item for Melville right now?
Memoirs of Melville?
Well, it's a scroll you can read that can do something, and you could decide what it does, but it has a better chance of succeeding because of its Melville's thoughts, you know, like an extra presence or whatever.
We could make it so that you can use that book. We'll treat it as a scroll. It won't be a scroll, it'll be a book because you can change the form of it.
Right.
And yeah, Memoirs of Melville.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Yeah, dude, what do you want that to do then? Name.
Yeah, and then before that, it's just a bunch of symbols and shapes of Curl reading his mind.
No, I think it's his last thoughts dying.
Yeah.
So they're like burnt into the page.
It's like his dying thought. Nate, what does that do? I'm going to let you decide that.
That's a good question, man.
You don't have to decide that right now.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, think on it.
Yeah. I'm just going to make a little question mark after. I just read my notes, Memoirs of Melville question mark. So I'll let you decide that.
Beautiful.
And yeah, okay, so continue on. You guys carry Melville to the pyre, take his book from him.
Across his arms and make him look as presentable as possible.
Hold on, we take Shiny.
I guess we could do that.
Curl only take one, but it's for remembering.
He licks his lips and opens the satchel. What do I find in this bag?
Oof, silver birdcage, torn off face of Arthur Higgins.
My scrolls, I'm gonna grab them scrolls if you don't
sure,
mind.
Me want face, that good for scam. You not know who Curl is.
I take Arthur's mask and put it in my hump satchel.
Okay.
I feel like no one right, would know who you are because
like a high riding backpack.
Right? Yep.
Like one of those like girl backpacks, those tiny little ones.
Yep.
Okay, I guess that will be good for your scams.
Curl points to his eyes and back at Soup.
You understand? We have to be friends now, otherwise Curl will kill you.
I'm going to turn to Karen. I don't think people know who he is regardless, so I don't think the mask would help, but okay. And I put the satchel on his by his feet, cross his arms, make him look presentable.
And then burn him?
And then burn him. You know, they were respectful.
They did.
Come on
they
now.
Did. You're right.
Come on now.
It's like, make him look presentable. Goodbye.
Yeah.
Whoosh. Like, what difference does that make?
You mean like in the keep?
Yeah.
And then I'm going to take the crown off my head and put it on his head and then burn him.
Oh, fucking A.
I like that.
Yep.
The body burns indefinitely. Curl and Sue are watching this body burn silently, paying their respects. Karen, too, is on Sue's shoulder. And you see this bright light, like, from behind you. Like, someone's walking up behind you with a fucking spotlight.
You know someone else coming out here?
No. I turn around with my staff ready.
And you see the man that you have been looking for, Curl, the whole fucking time.
I drop the staff, and I immediately go into a bow where my hands are touching the ground and all sorts of shit, and...
Brylord is here! I have searched far and wide!
I take my silver and just chuck it all over the ground in front of him.
I brought loot!
Curl?
It is me, Curl! I have been looking all over.
Curl, my boy. Where have you been?
Just getting loot.
Get stand up. Stand up, please. Please.
Stands up, you hear just the hump popping.
What's happened to you, boy? You look horrible.
Girl had a rough time. I got stuck in another butt.
Again.
Another.
Yeah, this is Soup and Karen. Soup is a...
This whole time, me and Karen are just kind of looking back and forth between each other and then the Bright Lord in this whole situation. I didn't actually think you were a real person. I thought he was just a little bit insane.
Why Curl lie about it?
No, he is insane.
Curl is Curl.
Well, any friend of Curl's is a friend of mine. Nice to meet you. Soup.
Soup!
Yes, yeah. That's my name. This is Karen, my wife.
And this is Mel!
And he points to the pyre.
My name is Rumba. I am the Bright Lord.
All hail the Bright Lord!
I hope he doesn't do this every time.
It's a 50-50. So, what are you doing up here?
We're here to kill Furnace.
The Furnace Miser?
Yes.
Beautiful. It looks like the sun has blessed us all this day.
It has!
Unblinking, wide-eyed, looking at the light.
That was exactly my destination.
You lead the way, Bright Lord. Find out Curl Bad Leader.
Firstly, what is this abomination?
And I point over to the skull.
There might be more loot. There's some pricks in there, too. I kill.
And then he killed our friend here.
You did what?
Not on purpose.
Firstly, why are you... You're both dead.
Yeah, we fix that tomorrow. Be fine. I show you.
I'll be dead for a while here. I don't want to take my chances with him right now.
Can I touch the Bright Lord and sense any soul fire? Because I've had so much.
Yeah, sure.
All right.
Give me a presence test. It was called DR12.
While you soak up the Bright Lord's light?
Soak up his radiance. Take D4 damage.
Damn.
Don't know. Touch him. Don't just know. Feel. You're kind of like, that's your intention. Like, ooh, does he have soul fire or whatever you call it mentally? Just so taken by the fact that he's there. That's kind of shadowed your previous thought. And as you guys are touching, well, as Curl's touching Rumba, Soup collapses completely.
What?
And
what?
The body in the pyre, the burning body, crispy, at this point, blackly charred shell, sits up.
Oh, no!
What the hell is happening here?
Mel is back!
I'm on fire. I'm on fire. I don't know what to do now.
Get out!
This is that flame. I'm just on fire.
Oh, he's...
He has body back.
But it's...
I'm on fire!
But the blue
flame...
It's
ever burning! I know, it's ever burning!
What does this do to him?
I don't know, you guys figure it out. It doesn't hurt him, obviously, though. I mean, you might...
Oh my god!
Karen swoops up around, and she's just circling around Soup's burning body. She's like, you motherfuckers, stop sniffing glue.
Oh my god, you can't even dare!
That's the best bastard.
This episode features an adventure that's an interlude from the Northern Darkness Jam submissions. This is Enter the Domicile from our friend Gaffy. Thank you, friend.
All right, Nate back here once again at the end of the episode to let you know that our Patreon's a little bit different now. Of course, you can still find us on all the same socials looking up the World Standard, but Patreon specifically has changed a little bit. We added a new $3 tier called Paul, which is general Discord access and knowing that you support us, of course. Our $5 tier is the standard bearer tier, but we've added now, of course, the Discord access, exclusive voting power, behind the scenes content, and getting the opportunity to name one of the potential NPCs we come up with in our main feed. And back up to our D-Pick agent $10 tier is, of course, bonus episodes, Discord access, exclusive voting power, behind the scenes content, NPC naming, and some Patreon shoutouts just for you guys. Otherwise, everything's all the same. Find us anywhere you're looking for the World Standard. Of course, as always, we hope that you love the show and don't sniff glue. I'll tell you right now, Jake is going to leave this in as the bloopers later where I can just be like, oh God, I can't wait to delete this.
Every 10.
What's this doing in here?
I just had to move it.
In the worst place you could have put it. Right? You put it in the place that we're going to use. So I'll have to move it again.
Absolutely.
I like
this curl walk, stands up perfectly straight, walks away. He's like,
these fools don't know.
Yes.
Oh, at the end of the movie.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be so fucking hilarious.
That's funny.
Oh, my God.
He was even, remember the vacuum scene?
Yes, I'm just going to
say. He was doing that for no reason now. Like, he wasn't actually, like, that wasn't, he was just doing it.
Yeah. He was Jared Letoing the shit out of
it. He might have been faking it behind the door, though, because no one saw him doing it.
Pap.
Yeah, hey there.
Oh, hey there. You want a pap? You
want to go down to the Duluth?
Oh, God.
I was thinking about bringing a goddamn lady down there, but, you know, the fucking the Vikings were on.
I fucking had to stay home.
You know?
You're not even changing your accent, Jared.
I'm trying.
Yeah.